for trading.
We're talking with David Fisher, the CEO of Landmark Capital. Before we went to a break, we were talking a little bit about Deutsche Bank, and we do want to talk about that again.
Well, Deutsche Bank is in trouble. Every week we've been watching Deutsche Bank, and it seems like just even since I was on your program 2 weeks ago, some major things have happened, some positive and some negative. It's kind of like our country. Our country is really divided, pretty much down the middle politically, and you know, on how to fix this thing. And I'm seeing the same things with the opinions that revolve around Deutsche Bank, and even what Deutsche Bank does and say. There's some analysts, it's almost like Lehman Brothers all over again when you start looking at this.
Don't say that.
But the reality is true. If you would have known that Lehman Brothers was going to fall, then people were saying it's going to fall, but most of the people were saying, no, buy Lehman Brothers. Like a week before Lehman Brothers went under, Wall Street was telling people to buy it. They're saying the same thing about Deutsche Bank last Friday.
Well, I don't know what people listen to.
Well, here's the problem with it. I have no problem buying Deutsche Bank as long as the fundamentals are there. But the equivalency of the Dow in our country is in Europe called the stocks, STOXX. It represents 50 instead of a 30. The Dow represents 50 of the blue chip companies in Europe. Deutsche Bank on August 16th gets delisted amongst Barclays and Commerce Bank. I mean, three major banks of the 50 got delisted. The banking system is in trouble. They're over-leveraged. On Thursday of last week, the stock plummeted 8%. There was getting ready to be a sell-off, and here's what happened. Twitter put out a tweet saying Deutsche Bank has settled a deal, or is close to settling a deal, between the Department of Justice, which the Department of Justice was asking for $14.1 billion of settlement fines for fraudulent banking practices, like Citi did and Goldman Sachs. And, you know, we did it, and Bank of America paid $16.7 billion for the same thing. Well, there's a $14.1 billion lawsuit from the Department of Justice against Deutsche Bank. They don't have $14.1 billion. If Deutsche Bank goes under, Fox News, this will put it in perspective, Fox News said last Monday, it will be like Lehman Brothers, a walk in the park. One analyst said, the other one, they had six analysts, they all agreed, it would be nothing compared to, Lehman Brothers would be nothing compared to Deutsche. The other one said, it'd be like going a day at the beach would be Lehman Brothers compared to Deutsche Bank. The other analyst said, immediately you'd have 1 to 2 of the 10 largest banks in America immediately, within 1 to 2 days, go insolvent, and within a week, 4 to 5 more will fall. That's how big Deutsche Bank is. This is Fox News saying this. Now, some analysts came out and said everything's all fine. Jamie Dimon came out because he's in the banking industry. Everything's fine. So people from the industry are saying everything's fine, but here's the problem I have. When a Twitter account gets set up that's falsified and says they struck a deal with the Department of Justice for $5.65 billion, and the stock rallies 14% the next day after falling 8. And then we find out on Saturday, the Wall Street Journal, Reuters, and Associated Press says the top management from Deutsche Bank and Department of Justice hadn't even met yet. It was just to stop the free fall.
Well, wow.
Market manipulation. I got the article right here.
Wow.
Okay.
Go ahead.
So my problem is, tell the news, be honest, and quit causing market manipulation.
Now, you've written this paper. You want people to all know about the coming bail-in, how to avoid it from affecting you. Also, you have it's all the information on how your IRA having physical metals and taking possession with no tax liability, all of this information. You made it also very, very affordable for everybody. You might want to say that because I think it's pretty awesome what you've done.
Well, you can roll over your LLC. The lawyer fees are somewhere normally between $9.95 to $19.95. I've worked with a lawyer that would have done thousands of these in the last 4 years that I worked with him, and he charges $385 outside of Arizona, $350 inside.
And that's another thing. I want people to understand that you can help anyone from anywhere as well. So you can call him for this information. His number is 602-287-9200. The website is landmarkgold.com. Go ahead.
So with Deutsche Bank, clearly is in trouble. Otherwise, they wouldn't have done this, whether they did it or employee or somebody or in the banking industry. Somebody did it, what I just described with the Twitter account. Why? Because they have $300 billion of money under management in citizens and in clients' bank accounts. And they don't have $300 billion. There was fear that there was CNBC talked about this, that there would be a run on the bank, Germany, of this week, because this happened on Friday, okay? They fear that there would be a run on the bank in Germany, and that would cause the stock to collapse. And then we would have a bigger than 2008 again, because putting into perspective, Carol, and that's what I'm saying, we're 1 to 2 headlines away. I'm going to go on the radio and say something now that's going to be very offensive to some people, not to offend them, but to get their attention. We have 3 months, and if nothing is done with Deutsche Bank, it will go under. Not my opinion only, but Fox News said that last week. They have what you call burn ratio, 3 months of burning capital unless they get a bailout. And it's illegal to bail out a bank from the euro. There's no entity too big to bail them out. The Fed has already said we're not bailing them out. And Angela Merkel has said we're not bailing them out, the Prime Minister, the Chancellor of Germany. So somebody better come and bail out Deutsche Bank, or else we will have a Lehman experience again. Here's why. There is $70 trillion in derivative risks, some say conservative, 62, okay, it's a large number, in Deutsche Bank, and there was $24 trillion in Lehman Brothers. There's 208 subsidiaries with Lehman, and there's 3,112 subsidiaries with Deutsche Bank. They cannot unravel the books fast enough. It's impossible to do.
So what will happen?
This is my concern. This is why I'm so passionate today. This is the scariest I've ever been. I'm disturbed what's happening, because there is no fix right now. Unless something rabbit comes out of the hat, we will see a meltdown. We have the laws now set up in our country for a bail-in, the Dodd-Frank Act. Get the literature. They'll read about it. When I went on national radio at the beginning of this week, my phone has rang off the hook 5 times as much than normal any other week talking about this, because this is real. My concern is we see this flood. The rain clouds are in the distance. I'd rather be 2 years too early to the flood than 2 days too late, because if this happens, it will make a walk through the park with Lehman Brothers.
His phone number is 602-287-9200. Call them. They have people there that will kind of go over everything with you. No pressure whatsoever. They want to inform you. They want you to have the information. You're going to get the coming bail-in, how to avoid it from affecting you. Everybody needs to have this. Give them a call at 602-287-9200. It's landmarkgold.com.
They have a few ways of fixing this global economic problem, with the United States first being $20 trillion in debt. But most countries are upside down. They're in debt further than their gross domestic product, the GDP. So you either got to inflate our way out of this problem, raising rates. We've already tried that. Yellen said it's not working. The markets reacted. They tanked in December of last year. And I said they weren't going to raise rates this year, and they haven't, have they?
No.
Okay. They're not going to raise it in December either.
They're waiting for after the election.
No, they're not going to do it.
Not even next year?
No.
Okay.
Not until the markets are healthy enough. The markets are not healthy.
Well, how can they get healthy? In this situation,
the Fed is creating a bubble. They're creating a stock market bubble right now. They're injecting capital. They have been, and that's what's causing the markets to go up. Not fundamentals of products based upon being sold and making a profit from goods and services, but buyback of stocks and corporate entities doing that, and the Fed injecting capital. That's the problem. The market needs to stand on its own 2 feet, but they're not letting it to. This is why we're going to have another bubble in the market. But the problem is that this time around, banks are more leveraged than they were last time, 2.5 times globally. And this is where we're going to have the problem of a bail-in. So that's why I say, get the money in the metals. If they flip the switch, you get protected. Gold, if they don't, and gold goes up, because financial calamity has caused gold to go up. It's up 24% year to date, even with this correction. 23% year to date with this correction. It's still the number one asset class. They got to fix it somehow. Inflate, devalue, or bail in.
Now, when you work with somebody, will you please tell them that this is not something that that you're here to scare anybody or anything like that, that you do believe in diversification and all of that?
I'm not here to scare people. I'm here to empower people with knowledge that there is something going on, just like there was in 2008, that most people were not aware of.
And we know it.
We feel it. Now, here's some facts. Get the literature. Do some research. Diversify. There's a biblical scripture that says put a portion to seven, a portion to eight, because you do not know what tragedy may befall you. I don't know what's going to happen. Nobody does. I just know that it's going to get worse if they don't fix it.
Get this information. Call them. The phone number is 602-287-9200, landmarkgold.com. He can help anyone from anywhere, and they want no pressure whatsoever. They just want to inform you, and I believe everyone should have this information. Again, their phone number, call them, is 602-287-9200, landmarkgold.com.